you. My name is Brianna Trigg. I'm the Education and Outreach Director at Voyagers Conservancy, and my job is to oversee our education programs that we run jointly with Voyagers National Park. So I'm really happy to introduce two of our special guests this morning who came to welcome you to Voyagers. I'll start with Kate Severson, who is our new head of interpretation. And then we also have the great honor of having Bob DeGross, our superintendent. Welcome you to Voyagers and really kick off this trip in style.
This is Mark. Yeah. So Mark and Brianna were our first introduction to the park. We filmed with them a couple of years ago. Mark is a gentle, sweet soul who just has the best of everything, and he's going to be with us multiple times this week. So can we say hey to Mark?
I have two welcomes I want to share with you. One is first, welcome to the superhighway. And the superhighway of that water that you can barely see right through the trees there and everything, but the superhighway of the waters of Voyagers National Park, northeastern Minnesota, northwestern Ontario, that go all the way from Lake Superior up into Hudson Bay, and that were the highway that facilitated an international trade for over 100 years. And it's really amazing when you go out there, because one of the primary purposes of Voyagers National Park is to maintain a scenery reminiscent to what those people would have seen, primarily the voyagers from Europe, interacting with the native people of northeastern Minnesota and northwestern Ontario. I want to welcome you home as well. For many years, I worked with a gentleman by the name of Gerard Baker. Working with Gerard, one of the things that he always said is whenever we meet people in natural areas, the public lands that are within the United States, we should always welcome them home. And the reason why is because no matter who you are, no matter what culture you're from, no matter where your ancestors are from, we are all from natural areas, right? We're all from natural spaces.
Angela Graham, Arkansas. K-12, K-2 Enrichment, 3-12 Gifted and Talented.
Karen Grady from Arkansas, and I'm on week 3 at my job. I was a GT specialist for 22 school districts, but now I am advanced learning and gifted program specialist.
Katie, grade 5.
In North Carolina.
North Carolina, yes.
Deanna, Alaska, and I'm moving to kindergarten and first.
I'm Adam from Wisconsin. I teach middle school science.
Rodney, 5th grade, North Carolina.
Helen, New Jersey, 6-8 STEM.
Greg, also New Jersey, non-formal education.
Greg is on our board, so we've invited board members, but Greg also went with us last summer to family camp.
I'm Debbie, Houston, Texas. I teach high school outdoor education, coach softball, archery. Now I'm doing air rifle. I just retired from coaching volleyball once, so I could come here because it's volleyball season now. And so that's me.
I am Chelsea. I was formerly 5th grade science, moved districts, moved grade level, so now I'm 7th science. And from Texas, the Dallas area.
Colleen from Wisconsin, and I am a 4K through 5th grade instructional learning coach.
I'm Ellen. I'm from Illinois. I teach 8th grade science, and I'm also a high school dance coach.
Kathleen from Illinois. I was teaching 7th and 8th grade STEM. I will be teaching 8th grade special ed when we get back in a week and a half, 2 weeks.
Karen, Illinois, teach 7th grade ELA.
Karen from Maryland, and I'm teaching high school forensic science and biology and co-sponsor of the Society of Women Engineers little electric car.
I'm Laura, Kansas City, Missouri, elementary interventionist.
I'm also Laura from Dallas as well. I teach 5th and 6th grade art.
Good morning!
Good morning!
Who are you people? We have just trained a new set of Voyagers to head up into the North Country, and it looks like you all will be guests here. Let me introduce myself.
You stay longer.
My name is Alexander McKenzie, and I am Scottish by birth, and I am a shareholder and a major financier of the Northwest Army. I would like everyone to raise their right hand, please. So, repeat after me. I swear to be a dedicated Voyager.
I swear to be a dedicated Voyager.
To never allow another Voyager.
To never allow another Voyager.
To become a Heavernaut without taking this oath.
To become a Heavernaut without taking this oath.
To paddle without complaint.
To paddle without complaint.
And always carry my weight.
And always carry my weight.
I will adhere to the code of conduct of a Hebronaut.
I will adhere to the code of conduct of a Hebronaut.
Which includes having a good time.
Which includes having a good time.
Now for our last and most important oath, and this is historically correct, I found, I promise.
I promise.
I will never kiss another man's wife.
I will never kiss another man's wife.
Without the wife's permission.
Without the wife's permission.
You are here.
Soup's on.
Woo!
So non.
Well, welcome guys to Steam in the Park. So if you haven't already figured it out, this looks a little different. If you've never been before, it's not gonna be a change for you. But if you have been before, it's gonna be a little bit of a change. But I think you're gonna walk away realizing how special this place is.
If you've been here more than a year, we have a pin recognition for you. So we're gonna ask our second year people, if you'll just come stand right up here, Laura Utley, Karen Grady, Greg Corvalon, Kathleen.
And then we're gonna now honor our 3 year people. So Karen Kraus, Deanna, Colleen, Debbie, Matt, and Helen Corvalon, our old people that have been here since 2021. So we're gonna ask them to come up, and that's Rodney and KT. Year, which was just something I wanted to do, but it turned out to be really special, is this book exchange. Have you meet your heart buddy. So in just a minute, when I say go, in some kind of fashion, you're gonna find your heart buddy, and you're gonna meet up. That's after 9 weeks. All right, so we're gonna do a little activity right now, and we're gonna ask you to create a bracelet. Yes, Taylor Swift has invaded Voyageurs. That sort of describes what you're looking for this week. So it could be the name of the park. It could be a word that you're thinking about. So at your table, you have a plate of beads. Some of those are glow-in-the-dark beads. Some of them are UV beads. Some of them are just colored beads. And then we have a plate of lettered beads. So you have skewers, a half a Hershey bar, and marshmallows, and graham crackers. We hope you've had a great first day. So thank you for today. We're gonna have a great day tomorrow. All right, good night, everybody. Be good. Don't let the bears and wolves bite. Woo! Love you, mean it.
Okay. Come and get it. Come and get it. More? We need more. Okay. Pod ready. Pod ready. All right.
We'll put it down on this.
Welcome to day two. Woo! We are so glad you're back with us. So, as you know, Steve and I do this 12 weeks every summer, but we can't do it when we're boots on the ground without people that volunteer and say, we've got you, especially at this park. So we just can't do it without them. There's just no way. So I would like to honor our ambassadors by giving them their own night sky field guide to the constellation, which also has a little cloth map in the back that you can hold up. So can I have the ambassadors over here, please?
Brianna probably got that I worked in the conservancy with Brianna, and part of why you're all here today. Thank you so much for being here. It's just a pleasure to have such a fine group of people in this beautiful space. My name's Moss, and I'm the education coordinator for the Voyageurs Conservancy. I've been here, this is going on my third year. All of our food comes from the land in some way or another, and I think as a culture we've kind of become a little disconnected from that. There's plenty of types of grass, including sweetgrass, that grow better and stronger when they are harvested. but you don't want to over-harvest them, and it's not the same for every plant. So everyone will get at least one leaf in their bed, let's say that. We're going to start by going this way.
I'll do it.
Yeah. And there's so many kinds of lichens. Oh, I could go on so much, but I'm just going to talk about one for now because this is a foraging class, and that's Usnea lichen. Usnea lichen looks kind of like this. This is a beard lichen. You might be able to tell. Beard lichen. Looks like an old man's beard. And I wanted to tell you a lichen story, so that's enough preface. I'll tell you a lichen story while I'm holding some lichen. So, once upon a time, Annie Algae was living her life so happily in the woods. Annie Algae was really, really good at making her own food. She was so good at making her own food, in fact, that she could make food just from sunlight. One day, she ran into Franny Fungus. Franny Fungus was really good at something else. Franny Fungus was really good at making structures. One day, there was a knock, and who was there but Bobby Bacteria? And it was a beautiful community of beings living in one space, and you could really say that everyone took a liking to each other.
Wow. That is the longest.
True. I was like, this is the extended version.
Yeah. Thanks for listening. I liken you.
Yeah. Continue eating.
But what I try in my class to do, because I love to write, is to put a lot of writing into my instruction. So I try to incorporate any type of interesting hands-on ways of doing writing. And journaling is a great outlet to do that for. So we're going to do a little journaling activity today. It is the I notice, I wonder, and it reminds me activity. So start a conversation, ask permission with whatever you pick, if you can observe it and use it in your writing today. But you pretty much will just have a conversation out loud or internally if you want for about a minute, and just think of everything that you notice about your object.
We'll break up this next activity into three little pieces. So for the first part of the activity, we're gonna have you pair up with your book buddy. One buddy is gonna stand behind Laura's tree over here, and the other buddy is gonna stand behind like this tree over here by Chelsea. So you are gonna have to switch spots. So if you are starting on this side, your goal is to end on this side. If you're starting over here, your goal is to end over here. Two activities are going to go along with, it can be referred to as forest bathing or grounding. What we're gonna do in our journals then is we're going to tap into our five senses. And so since trees are the focus kind of this year, you are going to find a tree in this area, and some are big enough that you guys can share with someone else. And you are going to find that tree, and you're going to think a little bit about the way that you might be able to connect to that using your senses. So what do you smell? What do you see? You're not going to lick it or taste it, but like, is there some kind of scent maybe associated with it that reminds you of something? So using those senses, and then you're just going to jot some notes down into your notebook about what it is that you feel is that connection to that tree. Just take a couple minutes to do a little journaling activity for yourself, whatever that might be, drawing, sketching, writing, song, poem, and something like that.
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Oh! Oh! Woo, 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 woo.
Hey everybody, it's game night!
Woo!
I don't have the music, but everyone just hum your favorite game show theme. Ready, set, go. Okay, that was good.
Boom, clap, 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 boom, 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 clap
snatch.
So close.
They are part of the National Park Lego Challenge. We're going to be doing it tonight. We want you to create something that tells the story of this place. So it could be trees with eagles on top of it, or it could be Rodney's first time in a canoe, or it could be the multiple times that we eat a day, or the campfires, or the Voyageurs see with a canoe. Yeah, s'mores. But something that would capture the story of this place.
Are you just pouring stuff?
Just in case we don't have enough crazy.
Right. I met the clone.
The first one of all of them.
I'm going to eat the next. You have to sing with me. It starts with an S and it ends with a T. It comes out of you and it comes out of me. I know what you're thinking, but don't call it that. Be scientific and call it SAT.
What?
Call it SAT.
What?
Call it SAT.
For a great night and be ready tomorrow morning. We'll have breakfast at 8. We'll do a little activity before we leave at 10. Wear your beautiful shirt. You don't have to wear anything else, just the shirt. No pants. We know each other by now.
Here we go.
Chow time! Oh, welcome everyone to day 3.
Woo-hoo! Thank you for that. So we're going to do an activity this morning called a paint chip photo challenge. Join our exciting Steam in the Park paint chip photo challenge. Grab a full paint chip and head out on the island to find natural wonders that perfectly match each color on your chip. Snap photos of your discoveries showcasing the stunning shades found in nature. From flowers to foliage to rocks to water. You're going to share your pictures in WhatsApp. And there will be prizes. 2, 3.
Oh! Oh!
Now, if you just got bit by a mosquito.
Ow!
While driving from the Twin Cities up to an unusual town called Virginia, we entered a hotel before our big trip, and it just reminded me of Jamestown Blue.
But Jamestown Blue really. Considering we're in the Midwest, reminded us more of the old prairie
and not Wall Street.
But if it were up to me, I would be breathing that fresh mountain air
and seeing those country redwoods and those heather fields.
But as I sit here in my hotel room, I am in awe at all of the handmade furniture that I see.
The handmade furniture reminds me of stopping at a little prairie sod house out there on the Badlands, where all of that just beautiful bleaker beige sandstone is found.
And as I was walking on that, where were we at?
The prairie sod.
At the prairie place. I stepped in some Valley Forge brown scat.
But it didn't smell bad because I had blue nose SPF on this hot summer day. So it was clear sailing.
At the end of this hot summer day, there became a very large rainstorm.
It just happened to be a Monday, stormy Monday.
So for breakfast, we had bagels and eggs on that stormy day, and I used Philadelphia cream crema on my bagel.
As I set out for the day, I grabbed my cream cloak to make sure I stayed dry.
I also put on my fancy pants that were cleaned in the lavender wash. Grabbed my plum martini as the approaching storm came.
But then I remembered this great secret.
We were preparing to go for the dinner party that was featuring Moroccan spice pomegranates, caliente. We had to start practicing our salsa dancing and the move, rustique.
Really?
Oh my
I used to bring it home.
So I had to stampede out of there.
Okay.
The state that I grew up in, the lakes and the woods and the waters here, where as a little boy, as an 8-year-old, taking one of my first wilderness canoe trips through Crane Lake and Sandpoint Lake and Namekin Lake, and then turning east and going up the Namekin River up into Beaver House and Quetico Lakes, part of the Quetico Provincial Park, Jean Lake, Maline Lake, down the Maline River into Lac La Croix, paddling past an Ojibwe village, an indigenous village on the north shore of Lac La Croix, when there was this amazing juxtaposition of sure, lumber buildings and such, but also traditional shelters made out of birch bark and things like that. And having this picture of these different sites and scenes that just captured my heart as we continue to paddle, going down around rapids and waterfalls and back into Namekin Lake and returning to Crane Lake and just being enamored with these woods and waters that I always grew up calling the canoe country, inclusive of the Boundary Waters Canoe Wilderness to our east, as well as Voyageurs National Park, and all of this. And so, in many ways, why do I call this place home? It's because it just stirs my soul, and it resonates within me. And it's a place that I want to be part of, preserving and protecting for generations to come, pass on to my kids and grandkids, and take those canoe trips with them as well, and show them places like we're going to see today. As we go to the historic grounds of Kettle Falls and things like that. We're going to get underway a little higher speed here and probably check out a couple of eagle's nests before we make our way to a place called I.W. Stevens Island, where we'll actually get off and walk around a little bit, and we'll learn more about that spot in just a little while. But as we get up on speed here, everyone, feel free to move about the cabin, as they say on airplanes, and get on out on the deck, enjoy the breeze, cool off, that sort of thing. All right, you guys, sounds good. Glad you're on board, and we're in for a good day today.
Melt your marshmallows, and then in your sugar cone you can add Reese's Pieces or Skittles or other graham crackers and sprinkles, and then put your marshmallow on top of it. But we want to see your best ice cream cold s'more. Buddy, hope you had a great day 3. We will see you tomorrow for day 4. Everyone say peace out!
Peace out!
Oh, that was sad. That was really sad. Do it again. Dale.
Peace out.
Okay.
Peace out.
Peace out.
Full attention. Hey, Ellen.
Breakfast time.
Woo!
Short to the point.
I have a fun tub here. Take something out of it and pass it around. Before I introduce myself or talk what I'm here to talk about, invasive species, which anybody come here for the invasive species? No. Nobody ever comes to national parks or voyagers to learn about our invasive species. Now people want to see wolves, bears, voyagers. but I still have the coolest job in the park. A little bit about myself and my background. I'm the invasive species ranger here at the park. I've done that the last 3 years. And for the 2 years before that, I've also been with the park. The first year, I was a one-year position with the Voyagers Conservancy.
Watch what I'm gonna do.
Crumple your official scrap papers into little balls. Throw it in the sun. So, walleye, go feast on your three pieces of food. That's what I have in my fish pocket.
Do fish have pockets?
I didn't know you had a fish are in my fish pocket.
Oh.
Guess what else is in my fish pocket? Another fish!
No. It's gonna be a mess.
No!
Guys, will you give Ranger Jackie a hand, please? Thank you.
And I've done all the things.
I know some of you have done string safari. Anybody who has not done string safari before? So it's pretty simple. And this is out of the nature journaling from John Muir's laws, right? And so what you're going to do is you're going to take the string and you're going to make a loop. And you're going to focus in on what is in this loop. And you're going to spend maybe 5 minutes sketching it. The whole thing will take about 15 minutes. Now, we get to be really serious, all right? So, it's time for our loon challenge.
This is lake-loving Lulu. I'm seeking my perfect life partner for dancing and preening under the stars in my winter of Lake Cobb.
Bonjour. It is me, Lex Featherington.
Looney, looney. Oh, I've got 8 gold medals. Oh, diving, looney, looney.
I'd like to introduce myself. My Ojibwe name is Hmong, but my name for you is yours.
I know I'm hard to resist, but no ducks need apply.
I'm all about enjoying the simple pleasures in life, diving for fish, gliding effortlessly across the surface, and basking in the tranquility of nature.
As we migrate, Lune Lue, oh, I slow my breath down for you. Hold it for 5 minutes, Lue Lue.
If you have a strong bond with nature and a love for the water, let's make some waves together.
I was an early bloomer. I've been an independent loon since I was 10 weeks old.
If you're a fellow wanderer with a love for nature, water adventures, and a talent for making haunting melodies, let's connect.
Don't leave me stranded. I'd like to go ashore.
Phones!
Anybody else?
There you go, Debbie. Y'all are welcome. This is the spot.
There you go.
That was a good one. It's still vibrating there.
Well, thank you all for having me here. My name is Austin Hopkins. I am a research biologist with the Voyagers Wolf Project. Both my parents are teachers, so I'm aware that you're all good people. So it's a real pleasure to be here. I just kind of ramble about what I do, and if you guys have questions, feel free to interject. Happy to answer anything.
63 national parks in the country, and they are all made a national park for pretty specific reasons.
As dusk falls, fireflies come out, small lights shining in the dark night. They float and fly like little lanterns in a big world. Each flicker is a quiet reminder of beauty. They don't just glow just for themselves, but for those who watch, reminding us of the small wonders around us.
In their light, we see our own light,
a reminder that we also have a spark inside of us. Our light is not just for the night. It shines through acts of kindness, creativity, love, and joy. Fireflies show us that even a small light can break through the darkness and bring beauty and hope.
We are like them, each of us a firefly, carrying our light to brighten the world around us. As we go through life, we must always look for the light in others, seeing the glow in every heart we meet. Our time at STEAM in the Park is ending, but the connections we've made will stay. We are now Firefly friends, united by the light we found in each other.
So as we watch their gentle dance, let's remember to shine our light, joining it with theirs to make the world a brighter place, one gentle glow at a time.
All right, there we go.
So,
huh?
It's Wheel Wild Weiss.
Wheel Wild
Weiss.
It's Wheel Wild
Weiss. So I went outside without my glasses, and you could see them nakedly.
Just to be clear, they're not coming to view them
naked, right?
Say it again.
They're not coming to view the Northern Lights naked.
Yes. Whatever feels
in the party. It'll be dark.
Whatever feels good to you.
I bet everybody join in too, wouldn't they?
Mm-hmm.
Come on, everybody. Baby shark, baby shark, baby shark, baby shark.
I get too well for that.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's pretty good.
That's good. See? They make me do silly things.
Well, you're with me.
Always me.
Being reserving just because he's got super messy.
Time.
And they all come running this way.
Yeah.